In this video, we're going to start the design of the glider. But beforehand, let's take a look at something real quick. Here on the left, I have an airplane showing the four forces of flight: lift, drag, weight, and thrust. In steady level flight, the lift is overcoming the weight of the aircraft, and the thrust is overcoming the drag of the aircraft. However, each of these four forces are not independent of each other. So looking here at the right, starting with weight, obviously an aircraft is made up of objects and objects have mass, so there's going to be a weight to the aircraft, which means we're going to need to provide lift to overcome that weight as we fly through the air. However, one of the byproducts of lift is drag. As we move air around wings to create that pressure distribution, and that pressure field has a resultant force, and that force can be broken up into a lift component and a drag component. And because of this, drag is a byproduct of lift. What that means is we're going to need a propulsion system to produce thrust to overcome the drag and provide enough forward movement to give us enough air across those wings. And of course, that propulsion system is made out of objects which have mass, which contributes to the weight of the aircraft. Let's say, for instance, you found out that you need to add more weight to the aircraft. Well, if you have more weight, then you're going to need more lift to counteract that weight. But when you create that extra lift, you're also creating extra drag. And so you're going to also need a little bit more propulsion, a little bit more thrust to counteract that drag. And that extra propulsion from the engine is going to create more weight on the aircraft, which means you're going to need more lift, which means you're going to develop more drag, which means you're going to need more thrust, which means you're going to have more weight. As you can see, we're starting to spiral out of control. Now, this brings up two points that I want to make. The first thing I want you to consider is, where do we start an airplane design? In order to know how much lift we need to produce, we need to know how much weight. However, to figure out how much the wing is going to weigh, we need to understand how much lift we need to provide so that we can design an adequately sized wing. So do we start with the lift or do we start with the weight? Now, the second thing I want you to consider is that this is not a simple analytical problem where we start with a couple of knowns, we have some formulas or some equations, we plug them into it, and we find out the answer. Rather, as illustrated by the spiral example that I just went through, aircraft design is more of an optimization problem where you're trying to find the right balance of parameters or the right balance of trade-offs to get the best solution out of the many possible solutions. Now, what is the best solution? That's where we're going to start the design of this glider. So let's get to it. Let's talk about the general process of this glider project. The design can be split up into three different phases or three different stages that we're going to call conceptual design, preliminary design, and detailed design. And then, of course, after detailed design is when it's going to get passed off to modeling and then to printing. And modeling printing in a normal aircraft project is probably going to be more part of the detailed design phase, but I broke them out here for clarity. So conceptual design, what is that? It's a very high-level design where we look at the mission, we look at some of the different configurations or layouts of the aircraft, right? Canards versus wings. What kind of tail configuration? Is it going to be a tail dragger? What kind of engine? Is it going to be turboprop? Is it going to be piston? And this is where we come up with a very rough back-of-the-envelope design of an aircraft. In preliminary design, we try and start sizing the aircraft based on estimates or very rough analysis. We might start excluding some stuff that we were considering in conceptual design, and we're just trying to come up with an initial design of the aircraft to be able to go out and meet the mission requirements. And then in a detailed design, usually the overall configuration or layout of the aircraft is pretty set, and you start moving into stuff like individual component designs or manufacturing. You might start doing some more high fidelity modeling. You might start looking at performing some better analysis or some better testing. And at this stage, you're more tweaking the design to get better results or to meet requirements. Now, as you can see, the design process usually starts at a very high level. And as you move through it, you start coming up with a more detailed design that has been refined from your analysis and your testing. So let's go ahead and get started with some conceptual design of our glider. So let's start the conceptual design by asking the question, what goes into a conceptual design? So what are some of the things that we consider when looking at an airplane design? The first would be the mission of the aircraft. This is what the aircraft's going to be used for. A passenger jet's going to be very different from a cargo plane, and that's going to be very different from a fighter jet. An airplane design is also driven by requirements. These would be the must-haves that either the customer or the supplier or maybe your management requires of you. Oftentimes, these would be the minimums and the maximums. Then there also might be new technology that you're trying to incorporate into an aircraft. For instance, what if you have a new composite flapping wings and you're trying to integrate these into an aircraft? Then, of course, particular laws and regulations. And then, like every other engineering project, there's the economics of it. There's demand versus budgets versus competitions, reuse, schedules, and the like. Now, this isn't a comprehensive list. It's just a few off the top of my head. So let's start the conceptual design. So let's start looking at the mission analysis, also known as ConOps. ConOps stands for Concept of Operations. Now, a handheld glider is going to have some interesting aspects when it comes to aircraft design. For instance, it does not have a propulsion system since it's going to be thrown by hand. And so that means performance parameters such as rate of climb, takeoff and landing distances, a lot of your different speeds, or maybe even your endurance, are not going to mean anything. And similarly, for a control system, it doesn't have any ailerons or elevators or rudders that deflect. And so performance parameters such as turn radius, maneuverability, load factor, and even some handling characteristics like the dynamic stability are essentially meaningless. Now, this is going to present a bit of a problem, and we're going to need to be a bit creative in our sizing or preliminary design of the aircraft, as we would be missing a lot of information that would be used in our constraint analysis. I have a plot here on the right of a constraint analysis, and it shows some of the different performance objectives, the performance curves, for different maneuvers based on wing loading. Normally, we can use these performance parameters to define a design space in terms of power loading or wing loading that we can shoot for as we initially size our aircraft. But as mentioned, many of these performance parameters are missing or meaningless since this is a handheld glider, so we're going to have to get creative. So what do we care about then when designing our hand-thrown glider? The first performance parameter that we really care about is range. When we throw the glider, we want it to go as far as possible. And so what we want to do is we want to try and maximize the range of our glider. Now, since it's hand-thrown and there's no propulsion system, the way that we're looking to maximize range is to maximize the lift-to-drag ratio. If we can produce more lift with less drag, the aircraft should go farther. The second objective is that we want the glider to return to trim after disturbances. That means if something like a little gust of wind comes and blows it so that maybe one of the wings dips down a little bit, it's going to want to correct itself and level out the wings again so that it can continue flying. So we're going to need to look at the static stability of the glider after we design it to make sure that we're obtaining a reasonable static stability from our glider. And then the third goal that we have is that we want it to be able to trim for different throws. We're not always going to throw it exactly the same each time, and we can't really control very well the angle that we throw it at or the speed we throw it at. We can get close, but there's going to be some variation in that throw. So we want to try and have some insensitivity to that throw. So we went ahead and talked about some ConOps or mission analysis. Now let's talk about some requirements. Believe it or not, we do have a requirement for this glider project. And that requirement comes from how this glider is going to be manufactured. If you remember in the introduction video, I mentioned that this is going to be a 3D printed project, which means we have to worry about the print area available in the 3D printer. Talking with All Visuals for You, the maximum print area available is shown here on the left. We have an area of 237 millimeters by 244 millimeters by 235 millimeters. Now, if I take the smallest one of those dimensions, 235 millimeters, and do a quick conversion to inches, I get 9.25 inches. Now, to give ourselves some margin, even though we don't need nearly this much margin, I'm just going to go ahead and say that I want to keep all of my dimensions under 9 inches. For instance, when looking at the fuselage length, or rather the overall length from the very tip of my aircraft to the very tail of my aircraft, I want that to be under 9 inches. Now, these are requirements that come from our quote-unquote supplier that need to be implemented into our glider design. With these things in mind, Let's move on to the next video. We're going to start the preliminary design of the glider, starting with the initial design of the main wing. I'll see you in the next video.